Hey guys, John from the John Muir Show here, and since Democrats retook the House of Representatives this past January, they have held no shortage of absolutely senseless hearings. Hearings that ended up making the Democrats who orchestrated the hearing look like total fools. I mean, when it comes to their Trump-Russia witch hunt, of course they had the hearings with people like Michael Cohen and John Dean and Robert Mueller, and Democrats ended up coming away looking absolutely terrible from all those hearings. It was just further proof that there is no evidence of any wrongdoing on the part of Donald Trump. But they had another one of those hearings yesterday pertaining to a different topic. This hearing that the House Democrats were holding yesterday, it was supposed to be on racism in policing. So, of course, on the left, there's this whole, you know, obsession with race. Everything has to be black versus white. And they keep on claiming on the left that, oh, police officers, law enforcement of all sorts, they are so bigoted and they're just going after these black people, not because they did anything wrong, but just because of the color of their skin. So they ended up holding an entire hearing on this yesterday in the Democrat-led House. And who was one of the individuals that the majority Democrats called that was supposed to be some expert in opposing racism and opposing, you know, racism in policing? That would be the Reverend Al Sharpton. I mean, that's just so laughable. You're trying to say that your goal is to fight racism, and you bring in one of the biggest racists that we have in the United States of America? That's supposed to be your star witness? Like, are you kidding me? I mean, these Democrats, they really do not plan any of this out, do they? It seems pretty clear they don't. But anyway, Reverend Sharpton did show up, and he was rightfully confronted by one of the Republicans on the committee. That would be Congressman Matt Gaetz of Florida. And Congressman Gaetz brought up that back in 2000, actually it was one of Al Sharpton's current fellow MSNBC stars, Morning Joe Scarborough, who had brought forth a resolution to criticize Al Sharpton for being a racist and for being an anti-Semite. And Gaetz went on to ask Sharpton, is it true that you said all these things? Comments like referring to black people who don't agree with him as cocktail sip Negroes, referring to Jewish people as things like white interlopers and diamond merchants, and also making the claim that if the Jews want to get it on, they can pin their yarmulkes back and come over to my house. And Al Sharpton had to admit that, yes, he did in fact say all of those things, showing that, yes, Al Sharpton has a long history of saying things that are racist and saying things that are anti-Semitic. Point proven, Al Sharpton is the absolute worst person in the United States of America to show up to a hearing where they're supposed to be combating racism. But really, big picture, look at this. This is how the Democrat majority in the House of Representatives is spending its time, which means this is how they are spending your tax money, because you're the ones paying for these sham hearings. You're the ones paying the salaries of these politicians, these Democrat politicians who sit there and insist on spending their days when they could be addressing the real problems facing the United States, trying to find real solutions to real problems. Instead of doing that, they waste their time and your money holding absolute dog and pony shows like this one right here. And hey, props to Matt Gaetz for calling it out for the BS it was, and for calling Al Sharpton out for the disgusting bigot that he is, because he is one of the biggest racists in the country. So if you really think that there's problems with some sort of racism in the United States, Al Sharpton, probably not the guy you want to call to fix it, because all he's going to do is just add fuel to the fire as the biggest racist in this country. And that's all the time that we have for today and for this week. John Muir Show back on Monday and each and every weekday, 8:40 a.m. WTAQ, 9 a.m. WSAU and WHBL. Till next time, I'm out.